9 years after the last space shuttle flight, NASA and SpaceX are targeting May 27th for the launch of Demo 2, the first launch of NASA astronauts from the U.S. since 2011, and the first crewed launch for Elon Musk's space company, SpaceX. NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine announced the launch date on Friday, the 17th of April. The historic test flight will herald the end of America's sole reliance on Russia for basic space transportation. This SpaceX Crew Dragon spaceflight has been in the making for years, ever since NASA selected SpaceX to develop new spacecraft to ferry astronauts to and from the ISS as part of the Commercial Crew Program. SpaceX has been transforming its Dragon cargo capsule, which has been taking supplies to the ISS for years, into a vehicle that can carry people. After 6 years of development, as well as various testing successes and failures along the way, the capsule is ready to finally carry its first passengers on a flight test. The mission had been previously announced to be tracking toward a mid to late May launch timeframe, but now we know exactly when NASA and SpaceX hope to launch astronauts for this inaugural trip to the International Space Station. As its name implies, Demo 2 will be the second time SpaceX launches its Crew Dragon capsule to the International Space Station. But unlike Demo 1 last year, this time two astronauts will be on board. The Demo 2 mission will represent a major milestone for Musk's SpaceX and its goal to begin regularly flying people to space. The company has been launching spacecraft, satellites, and cargo since its founding in 2002, but never humans, professional astronauts, or otherwise. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss how NASA and SpaceX are gearing up to send the first astronauts to the International Space Station from the U.S. in a decade on the 27th of May. Let's get into details. NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine said in a tweet that the agency aims to once again launch American astronauts on American rockets from American soil. Bridenstine announced the long-awaited target launch date hours after a Russian Soyuz ferry ship brought two Americans, Jessica Meyer and Drew Morgan, home from the space station, and just 8 days after astronaut Chris Cassidy used the agency's final contracted Soyuz seat to reach the lab complex. He will be the lone American aboard the station until the SpaceX Crew Dragon arrives. If all goes well, Demo 2 is set to take off at 4:32 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time from Launch Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley will be strapped into SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule that's sitting on top of a Falcon 9 rocket. The slender two-stage booster will climb directly into the plane of the space station's orbit, releasing the capsule to fly on its own about 10 minutes after liftoff. From there, Behnken and Hurley will monitor a mostly autonomous rendezvous, catching up with their quarry the day after launch. Following tests of the spacecraft's navigation and manual control systems, the crew will move in for docking at the lab's forward port around 11:30 a.m. on May 28th. The SpaceX Crew Dragon flying this mission is designed to stay on orbit for around 110 days, but its actual length of stay will be decided by how ready the Commercial Crew mission to follow is at the time of launch. That Crew Dragon, which is the fully operational version, is designed for stays of at least 210 days, and the crew complement of 4 astronauts. SpaceX Crew Dragon from Demo 2 will perform an automated undocking from the ISS with Behnken and Hurley on board when it's ready to leave, and then they'll re-enter Earth's atmosphere and have a controlled splashdown landing in the Atlantic Ocean, where a SpaceX ship will pick them up and bring them back to Florida. It will be the first astronaut splashdown since the joint Apollo-Soyuz mission in 1975. Before the coronavirus pandemic swept across the country, NASA managers were expecting huge crowds to gather along Florida's Space Coast for launch, along with hundreds of journalists at the Kennedy Space Center. It's not yet clear how that will play out, given social distancing and other safety protocols. Though Bridenstine noted that NASA and SpaceX are taking extra measures to protect the astronauts and other workers given the coronavirus crisis. On April 1st, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis issued a stay-at-home order for residents in the state to help combat the spread of COVID-19. Meanwhile, NASA has issued mandatory telework policies at all of its centers, with exceptions for essential personnel. However, the space agency says it's monitoring the pandemic as it prepares for the launch. The Florida Space Center is currently closed to all but essential personnel as part of NASA's COVID-19 response framework. Bridenstine said in a recent interview, "The managers, engineers, and technicians working to ready the Crew Dragon and its Falcon 9 rocket for flight are taking all possible precautions. About 350 NASA employees work for the Commercial Crew Program, using personal protective equipment when needed and are working in rotations. The agency is making sure that we're practicing all of our social distancing measures," Bridenstine said. "We're using shifts of workers in a way that we can enable more distancing. But even if people don't feel safe, they don't have to work on the mission," he said. "I've been very clear with all of the agency leaders that nobody should feel pressured to do work if they don't feel safe." If a positive case of coronavirus is confirmed among the launch team, depending on where it is and how the person is doing the work, it may or may not impact the mission, Bridenstine said. "What we're trying to do is make sure that if there is a case, that we can quickly identify the people that the person was in contact with and do the tracing and get all the people that were involved off the mission and replaced with other people. If there's an outbreak, yeah, it'll affect the date," he said. "But we're doing everything we can to minimize that eventuality." NASA also said its astronaut trainers are closely adhering to CDC recommendations on infection control, with a limited number of employees coming in contact with Behnken and Hurley. "We always quarantine all the astronauts before they go to the International Space Station," Bridenstine said. "Now we're taking even more precautions." Bridenstine earlier this month explained why Demo 2 has been a priority for the agency. "We need access to the International Space Station from the United States of America. Commercial Crew is the program that's going to make that happen. It's essential for our country to have that capability," he said. The final test will validate each aspect of the Crew Dragon and Falcon 9 launch system, including the pad from which the rocket takes off, the operational facilities on the ground, orbital systems, and astronaut procedures. Pending successful completion of all those elements, Crew Dragon should be set for full operational certification, after which time it can begin regularly scheduled service of delivering astronauts to and from the ISS. But the coronavirus is a major complication in an already complicated set of interlocking initiatives aimed at ensuring the uninterrupted presence of U.S. astronauts aboard the International Space Station. As a hedge against possible downstream problems or delays in the agency's Commercial Crew program, NASA is negotiating with Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, for a seat on board the October Soyuz flight and another next spring. But if SpaceX Crew Dragon test flight goes well, NASA and SpaceX are expected to launch a second Crew Dragon, Crew 1, later this year. Crew 1 mission, which the agency considers to be Crew Dragon's first operational flight, will mark the official start of SpaceX flying astronauts on regular missions to the ISS. NASA is expected to launch Crew 1 carrying a crew of four: Mike Hopkins, Shannon Walker, Victor Glover, and Japanese astronaut Soichi Noguchi. They would presumably remain aboard the space station for 5 to 6 months before returning to Earth. The Commercial Crew program was launched following a 2004 decision by the Bush administration to complete the space station and retire the space shuttle by the end of the decade. After a series of preliminary studies, a NASA-funded competition began in 2010, and on September 16, 2014, the agency announced that Boeing and SpaceX would share $6.8 billion to develop independent space taxis, the first new U.S. crewed spacecraft since the 1970s. NASA has awarded SpaceX more than $3.1 billion under the Commercial Crew program to fund development of the capsule. SpaceX company is also contributing hundreds of millions of dollars of its own funds when needed. Boeing is also developing its Starliner spacecraft to compete for contracts, with the company having received more than $4.8 billion in awards since commercial crew began. Boeing will rely on a United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket for the trip to orbit. The CST-100 Starliner capsule will land in the western United States. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.